So what do you think the first touch is going to be like?
You know, it's hard to predict. I won't be able to see much, so just going to kind of have to go on feel.
Okay. What do you think she's going to feel like?
Hopefully as nice and as soft and I'm sure she looks.
Are you nervous?
No, just excited.
If you need to cross your, I'm about to do their first cut. So if you need to do
Can't
your
turn.
Go ahead. Do you feel comfortable? Your arm okay?
Yeah, hold on. I have more stuff in my heart.
He's got to move his weapon.
That was the right decision. It was something that was a different idea to me, and I'm very glad we did it. It was a very special moment.
What did you think about the letter?
That's about as emotional as I've felt. I don't know what else to say beyond that. It was just a private, special thing.
So let me read you. Everyone gets to hear. Look, no, it was very nice. He cried.
Oh, really?
Which was, I felt kind of bad because I didn't think I did that good of a job.
And you could just hear him stiff.
I know. I was like, I'm really sorry. I didn't think I did that well. Yeah, it went good. It was good. You know, Party Central.
So. Without further ado, are you all ready for Lindsey and Julius' wedding?
Yes!
All right then, let's get going then.
Thank you.
best wedding I've ever been to.
It was all right.
It's the only wedding I've ever been to.
Okay, see, it was just...
But it was the best.
Thank you.
Why do we do it? The marriage ceremony has been an important feature across nearly every culture, religion, generation, and society. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but this one is regarded one so critical that we acknowledge its special status by sharing it with others. So why this moment? Because despite all of our differences, love is what we all share. It is the great unifier, our one universal truth. That no matter who we are, where we come from, what we believe, we know this one thing. Love is what we're doing right. That is why you're both standing here. That's why we're all here. We have all loved in our lifetimes, and in this moment we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of our humanity. All of us here today have our own love stories. Some are short, others long, and some are yet unwritten, while others are just getting to the good part. There are chapters in all of our stories that are sad or disappointing, and others that are exciting and full of adventure. All of you have played a part in how their story has unfolded, and they are grateful to be surrounded by so much love and support. And that brings them here, a time to pause, look back, and smile at all the moments that brought them here, and a time to look ahead at all the moments that are still to come. I'm here, and I think we're all here, because we want those moments for you. We're here to hope with you, to support you, and to be proud of you, and to remind you that love isn't happily ever after, and love is the experience of writing your own story. It is not one moment, not even this moment. It's every moment, big ones like saying I love you, moving in together, getting engaged, but mostly the million little ones that come in between those big moments. Falling asleep next to each other, making dinner together, spending holidays with your families, binge watching Netflix, getting a big hug when you get home from work. These everyday moments fuse together into one big experience. And even though this experience is so incredible, words fail us when we try to explain it. That's just the way it is with love. It's meant to be felt, not described. But trying to describe love is one of our favorite pastimes. We use the words we have to write stories and poems and songs about love. And even though we describe love in different ways, and even though love looks different from one person to the next, we all know it when we see it, and we see it here. So you fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You both are choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, makes you think, makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. So you're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to vow to take care of each other, to stand up for one another, and find happiness in the other. There's a simple premise to each of these promises. You're vowing to be there. You're teaming up and saying to the other, every experience I'm going to have, I want you to be part of. So Lindsey and Julius, with your family and friends as your witnesses, do you present yourselves willingly and of your own accord to be joined in marriage? Will you promise to care for each other in the joys and sorrows of life, come what may, and to share the responsibility for growth and enrichment of your life together? So will you, Julius, keep Lindsey as your favorite person, to laugh with her, go on adventures with her, support her through life's tough moments, be proud of her, grow old with her, and find new reasons to love her every day? Will you, Lindsey, keep Julius as your favorite person, to laugh with him, go on adventures with him, support him through life's tough moments, be proud of him, grow old with him, and find new reasons to love him every day. So I'm gonna take a break. So you both have chosen to wear rings as a reminder of these promises. People often say bands are a perfect circle with no beginning and no end. But these rings did have a beginning. The stones were formed a long time ago, deep within the earth, and eventually a series of lucky events caused them to rise to the surface, where someone dug them up. Metal was then liquefied in a furnace at 1,000 degrees, molded, cooled, and painstakingly polished. Something beautiful was made from raw elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of serendipity and effort, imperfect beings shape into something extraordinary. It is a process of making something beautiful where there is once nothing. So Julius, could you take these rings and place it on Lindsey's finger? And repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love and faithfulness to you.
Of my love and faithfulness to you.
Take this ring and place it on Julius's finger. So Lindsey, repeat after me.
Yeah, ring. Hang on,
I'm ready.
I give you this ring. I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love and faithfulness to you.
Of my love and faithfulness to you.
You're welcome. So as you look at these rings over the years, I hope you remember that something beautiful was made from raw elements. You've created something invaluable. And just as I know you'll protect these rings, I'm confident you'll protect these commitments. So having pledged their fidelity to one another, to love, honor, and cherish one another in the presence of this gathering, and by the authority vested in me by the Constitution and the laws of the state of Florida, it is my honor to now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
I love you both so much. I wish you every happiness in the world. Lindsey, since you came into his life, he is a better man, and I love you both so much.
Guys, I gotta tell you, today was a celebration. I can't even express to you how proud and how happy we are for the two of you. I gotta tell you, Julius, I'm so glad you got married, you're getting older. You cost me a lot of money. Between baseball and, I mean, I just, hey, it was worth every penny. I love you. I think you guys are great together. And the fact of the matter is, Lindsey, are there a lot of those in London? Talk to you later. Love you.
Are you guys ready to meet the wedding party?
Until I got here. And then I wanted to stay. I'm really happy for you guys.
No.
You know that, Lindsey and
Julius for like 2 years now.
Pretty great.
Yeah,
on everybody's mind is, will you be sleeping with Mary tonight?
You guys, Lindsey put you up tonight, man. No, I will not be sleeping with Mary tonight.
Thank you. question I need to ask you is, are you sleeping with Scott tonight?
I'm sorry?
Are you sleeping with Scott tonight?
She knows better. I am not sleeping with Scott tonight. It will be a cold day in hell until, you know, when I sleep with him ever again. And there are no cold days in hell, so there you go, Lindsey. You have your answer. Quit saying we're getting back to
you. No way.
So I just want you to know that, in the words of Michael Scott, I am a early bird and a night owl, and therefore, I not only am wise, but I also have worms. Colleen?
Lindsey, I love you to death. I love all the phone calls. Where is Mother Mary? I don't know where she is. She won't answer her phone. Julius, here's to the beers and the future beers that you
absolutely.
And I enjoy together. We have the same taste. Couldn't be better. Love you.
Love you guys both.
Have
love
fun.
Thank you. Yeah!
Derek, this is my fiance Bella, and yeah, we were really happy to be invited today. It was awesome, and we wish Lindsey and Julius the best. Have a happy marriage.
Thank you.
expected that.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Have a great time.
It's been fun to watch you, Lindsey, grow up. We've just loved it. And
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Bang! Congratulations. You guys rock.
Paid for this? This little
child's farting right now. I'm not lying. Anyways, if this goes viral, I will accept 10% at least. I was really upset because Julius didn't even want to let me sing a song.
No, we've already, no.
I don't know, I think they should have gave him a chance at least.
A chance.
No, we've already talked about this.
Just one chance is all
no.
I needed.
You don't sing a song, it was for speeches.
Danny, wait, no. Yeah. You want to sing?
Just doesn't get it.
Going to weddings is what I do best. Really bittersweet. It's like chocolate. Who are you helping? But yeah, bittersweet, like I was saying. Sweet because I love the people here. I'm so happy for Lindsey and Julius. Bitter because it was double XP weekend, so.
Okay, awesome. Let me win, I don't wanna remember this. Baby, win, I don't wanna remember this.